I don't feel comfortable in Mystery Babylon.
I myself would love to move somewhere else in the world. But I want to share with you my belief on who Mystery Babylon is. You see, I believe the United States is in Bible prophecy, but I don't believe it's Mystery Babylon. Mystery Babylon is a term we find in Revelation chapter 17, verse 5. And it reads, "Upon her head was a name written, Mystery Babylon, the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth." Notice also in this chapter, it refers to Mystery Babylon as a woman. This woman is also introduced as a harlot. She's introduced as wearing scarlet and having names of blasphemy and other things. Now, in Bible prophecy, a pure woman represents a true godly church. A corrupt woman, however, represents an apostate church. Please screenshot those texts, look them up, and confirm what I'm saying. So when the Bible calls Mystery Babylon a mother of harlots and a woman, it's actually saying that she's a corrupt apostate church. Mystery Babylon is a religious system. It's not a secular nation. Notice that it says she's the mother of harlots. Why is that? We're going to get into it. Pause to read this text. Now, there's a few main chapters in the Bible where the Bible gives us several key characteristics of how to identify Mystery Babylon. The Bible also refers to this organization as the Antichrist, the man of sin, the son of perdition. So let's get into it. In Daniel chapter 7, we see the first few. This Antichrist Mystery Babylon power has 10 horns. The Bible says 10 horns are 10 kings. Now in this study, we're going to follow the rule of Isaiah 28, and that is that we're going to compare scripture with scripture, line upon line, precept upon precept. So this Antichrist Mystery Babylon power would arise from the midst of these 10 horns or 10 kingdoms. It will be a different kind of king and will subdue three kings. Now I'm going to come right out and tell you, this is the Roman Catholic Vatican, the papacy. They are the Antichrist. They are Mystery Babylon. They are the son of perdition. They are the mother of harlots. Let's get into why that is. You see, the Bible says they would arise from around 10 other kings or kingdoms. Now, as we'll see in a little bit, Revelation 13 says that they would arise from the sea. And Revelation 17 says waters represent highly populated areas. Where did the Vatican arise from? Western Europe, in Italy. So these 10 horns, these 10 kings, are the original 10 nations of Western Europe. But it says it would be different. How so? Well, the Roman Catholic Vatican is its own nation. It is a religious and political secular power. That's what makes it diverse from the other nations of Western Europe. Then it says it shall subdue three kings. In the 500s, the early 500s and late 400s, the Vatican had gone after three kingdoms, the Vandals, the Heruli, and the Ostrogoths. And by 538 AD, they had destroyed all three of these kingdoms. That's when the Bible says, he shall subdue three kings. Then the Bible says that this Antichrist, Mystery Babylon, the papacy, would speak pompous words against God. The word pompous is blasphemous. The Pope claims the title of Vicarius Filii Dei, Vicar of the Son of God. You look up their quotes, and they also claim to be Jesus under the veil of human flesh. They claim to hold the place of God on earth. They claim to be God. They also claim to have changed times and laws. You look up again their quotes. They take credit for changing the Sabbath from Saturday to Sunday. And they admit there's no scriptural justification for that change. The Bible says they would also rule for a time, times, and half a time. It also refers to the same time prophecy by the terms of 1260 days and 42 months. Now, according to Numbers 14 verse 3 and Ezekiel 4 verse 6, a day in Bible prophecy represents a literal year of time. So this 1260 year, 42 months, 3.5 year prophecy is actually 1260 literal years. And it started when those three kings were subdued, which happened in 538 AD, is when the last kingdom was subdued of those three kings. And they ruled until 1798, and we'll come back to that year in a minute. Please pause to read this as well. The papacy arose out of the sea, the prophetic sea, meaning out of densely populated Europe, as we mentioned earlier. They sit in seven mountains among and rose among the nations of Europe. They have the blasphemous name, which we talked about already. They have all the different characteristics of the pagan religions of Daniel chapter 7 and 8. And the Bible says they are controlled by Satan himself. Now the Bible also says in Revelation 13 that they would receive a deadly wound, in 1798 specifically. In that time, the French nation was having an upheaval, and they actually marched into the Vatican, took the Pope captive, and that was their deadly wound, and they have not enjoyed the same amount of power since. However, the Bible says in the same verse as the deadly wound mentioned, that that deadly wound would be healed, and we're watching that happen before our very eyes. Almost the whole world is in love with Pope Francis. As we mentioned earlier, it sits in the middle of Italy, and it is its own religio-political nation, as we mentioned. Where does the United States fit into all of this? Well, the Bible tells us that around the same time that the first beast, that is the Vatican in Revelation 13, would receive its deadly wound, there would be another nation rising up out of the prophetic earth around that same time. And when the land area, now known as the United States, was beginning to be colonized by Europeans, it was a slow-growing process. That's what it means by coming up. It's slow growth. Now, the Bible says it would have two horns like a lamb, but would speak as a dragon. This nation was founded on two principles: religious freedom and no king. They wanted a nation without a king and a church without a pope. So, religious and political freedom. And for a long time, once this country was founded, that's what this nation really enjoyed. But it says this nation, the United States, would speak as a dragon. Revelation 12 identifies the dragon as being Satan. So this nation, the United States, will soon speak or write laws like Satan. That's how a nation speaks, is by writing laws. So the Bible goes on to say that the role of the United States will eventually be to force the world to worship the first beast, the Roman Catholic Vatican. Now please understand, when we mention Catholicism in Bible prophecy, we're not speaking against Catholics, we are speaking against a false religious system of deception. The Bible goes on to say that there would be a false religious revival here in the United States, and there would be an image made to the beast. So if the Roman Catholic Vatican is represented by a harlot, impure woman in Bible prophecy, the image to the beast is going to be the same kind of organization. It will be an apostate religious system, but here in the United States. So this will be an apostate Christian system. Soon, the evangelical Christian world of the United States will seize control of the United States government and will force it to enact religious laws. Now, the Vatican claims that their mark of authority is changing the Sabbath to Sunday. So when they enforce the Sunday law by government law, that will be the mark of the beast. It's not a tattoo, a chip, or anything else. And it's going to be the apostate evangelicals of the United States that enforce it. And that's what the Bible means when here in Revelation 17 it calls Mystery Babylon, the Vatican, the mother of harlots. Because all of these apostate Christian denominations in the United States and across the world, they're going to form that image of the beast mentioned in Revelation 13, and that's what makes them the daughters of Mother Babylon. Now, if you'd like to learn more, you can watch my Antichrist Mark the Beast playlist. You can go to my YouTube channel and watch the Landmarks of Prophecy playlist. Or you can simply look up Amazing Facts, Panorama of Prophecy on YouTube with Doug Batchelor.